Hello everyone, this is Abhinesh Krishnan. Welcome to my another video, and sorry about making videos. It was delayed because I've been busy with my night shift work, as well as I've been filing my police clearance certificate, and also I'm busy with my visa and other stuff, because my visa runs out on March, so I need to file my visa. And so let's get started with this video. Two information I'm going to share, which is how to file a police clearance certificate while you're in New Zealand. This is people who are in New Zealand, currently in New Zealand, who are looking to extend their visa, or people who are in student visa requiring any government formalities to be done in New Zealand. This video is for you. So let's get started with it. So how to file a police clearance certificate. So basically, there are certain procedures you need to follow while you are doing a police clearance certificate. It depends upon what passport you have. You can, if you are from a different country other than India or any other country, there is a link down below this video which I have left. You can click on that link, and there would be a tab box which you need to select which country you belong to, and residing outside country. So that's the option you need to select and follow the procedures based on it. Basically, let me share my experience, because I belong to India and I have an Indian passport. So once you select those options on your immigration website, certain steps will be followed by it. So first thing is, you have to download a form called High Commission of India Wellingtion. So basically, government offices are available in Wellingtion, so you have to file all the government formalities to be done in Wellingtion. If you are directly in Wellingtion, that's no problem. Like, you can file you can download the form and fill out the details based on it. And once you fill out the details, there should be a $40 check which you need to take for police clearance certificate. You can go to the nearest ANZ bank to get the police check. Just tell them like you are filing for your police clearance certificate. They would give you a printed check of High Commission of India Wellingtion, and this information is already available on the application form. So you can follow the procedures based on it. And once you get the check, just go to the nearest New Zealand post, and then take a courier bag, like two courier bags. One should be from address and to address. To address is Wellingtion of High Commission Wellingtion of India Wellingtion, which will be available on the application form. Fill out those details and put your original passport in the cover, as well as put the other cover where your address should be filled on the other cover. Two covers, one from and to address, and the other cover only your address should be filled, and put it on the courier bag with the application form and the check. Give it to the courier person, who would do it for you, and they would charge you for around $22, which they did for me. And High Commission of India verifies your information, and once the police clearance certificate verification is done, they would send your passport back to you. So to send the passport back to you, they need a bag of courier. So that's the reason you're sending two courier bags with it. And you would get an email on the second day itself, they have received it and so on. So like, your confirmation has been done, and it takes around 15, maximum 15 days to receive the police clearance certificate. And basically, whatever government information or anything, birth certificate or driver's license or whatever in it, it is based on government. You need to go to High Commission of India Wellingtion. In that website, it is already available. So if you're living in Wellingtion, you can fill the form and directly go to the government office, and you can pay directly. You don't need a check. And that's all for this video. And sorry, I forgot to say another thing. Realme account is basically an essential information which I need to share. It is useful to file your tax return and your visa extension, and all the government stuff can be done on the Realme account. So it is essential to create the Realme account. I've left the links down below on this video. Just click on the link and follow the procedures, instructions. If you're in New Zealand, you can do it. And people outside New Zealand who are watching this video, just know the information. Once you come to New Zealand, just create a Realme account, which will be useful for you for filing your tax returns, as well as extend visa formalities or whatever government things which you need to do via Realme account, which will be useful for you. And that's all for this video. If you're looking for any other information or anything, leave it down in the comments below. I will make a video out of it. See you soon in the next video. Bye bye.